Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for summer 2018-19. The drought continues in many areas, even though El Nino hasn't locked in yet. Summer looks drier than average across the north and warmer than average for most of the country. But first, let's look at recent conditions. Following Australia's driest September on record, some places had heavy rainfall in October and November, thanks to tropical moisture and spring thunderstorms. On the 20th of November, Strawn in Tasmania had its wettest November day on record, with over 63 millimetres. Spring was close to average for Australia as a whole, with below to very much below average rainfall in the southeast, far southwest, and Tasmania. Unfortunately, recent rains have made little difference to serious and severe rainfall deficiencies in many parts of eastern Australia. Serious deficiencies also continue for inland areas where strong winds over dry soils kicked up several large dust storms. Spring temperatures were above average across the country, resulting in one of the warmest springs since records began more than 100 years ago. Early heat waves occurred in several areas. For instance, Birdsville recorded 44.7 degrees on the 25th of October, the earliest in spring that a temperature that high has ever been recorded in Queensland. Warmer and windier than average days meant rain was more likely to evaporate than to soak into soils. As a result, soil moisture continues to be below average across parts of eastern Australia, and inflows into water storages have been far lower than at this time last year. Storages in the northern Murray-Darling Basin are down to 17% overall. Sydney's main water storage, Warragamba Dam, has dropped almost a quarter of its capacity and is now at its lowest level since the end of the millennium drought. So what's influencing our climate at the moment and for the coming months? A positive Indian Ocean dipole has been in effect since early September, but is expected to decay in the next month. In the tropical Pacific, ocean temperatures now exceed El Nino thresholds. However, the atmosphere has yet to fully respond. Until cloud, wind, and pressure patterns reinforce those in the ocean, the event is not locked in. As a result, our ENSO outlook remains at El Nino alert. In the southern Tasman Sea, higher air pressures are likely to drive more humid air further inland than normal. This has reduced the chances of dry conditions over southeastern Australia. So what's the rainfall outlook for summer? Well, much of northern Australia will likely see a slow start to the wet season, particularly over northern WA. Southern Australia shows no strong swing towards wetter or drier than average conditions. Summer temperatures are very likely to be above average over most of Australia, with heat waves remaining likely in southern areas. This could keep soils dry, even if rainfall returns to near average. So in terms of stream flows, with soils already dry and warmer than average temperatures likely, low stream flows are expected at nearly 90% of forecast locations up to January. Bushfire risk may have eased in the short term following recent rains in parts of the south, but even a brief spell of hot, dry weather will see the risk go straight back up. So in summary, rainfall is likely to be below average in the north. Temperatures are likely to be warmer than average with a risk of heat waves, and low stream flows are forecast for much of Australia. For more details, visit our website at bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 20th of December. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.